Children, nice to meet you all. I think you have heard the first part which I have explained. Now let me go to the second part in the same, okay, in the same story. What happened? Where did we stop in the last video? We were thinking about the mother. Who was crying? Seagull was crying. For what? For food. Did the mother bring and give or not give? I told you to read the lesson. I think you have understood. So now let us see what happened next. Okay. Here, actually, see, the seagull was crying. How she cried, you know that. Okay. Now, by seeing the cry of the seagull, mother was back. She bought a piece of fish. And she came near, but her mother's his mother's wish is to make seagull fly, but seagull is not flying. She is going on crying for food, and she is very nervous. He is very nervous also. Now see, but he kept calling plaintively, and after a minute so he uttered a joyful scream. His mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. He leaned out means when mother is bringing, he's just going to take that one. Say when you take food to the small children, they just open their mouth, they come to you to take that part, isn't it? He leaned out to his mother. But down, if he leans down directly, he may fall in the water. So what happened? So he leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock. Okay. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. Okay. So he was tapping the rock. Tapping means slowly beating the rock with his feet like this. Come on, bring, bring, bring. So trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. But when she was just opposite to him, she halted, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. When he was tapping the rock, he was feeling happy. Oh, my mommy is bringing food. My mommy is bringing food. When he was very happy, then what happened? Mother stopped bringing the food to him. Okay. Next, he waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer. And then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. He waited for a few minutes. Why mommy is not coming near me to give the food? Why she stopped? She is very close to him. Middle is the sea. She is very close to him. Suddenly she stopped. Why she is not stopping? Why she is not coming to me? Why she is not coming and giving me food? So what did he do? Suddenly he dived at the fish. Dived means jumping at once. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. So, with a big shout, he jumped downwards, upwards, downwards, upwards, downwards. Directly he fell into the sea. Up, down, the air, isn't it? You know the air will, the motion of the air, the movement of the air makes you up and down. Like that, from up he was rolling and he fell down. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards. How did he fell? Outwards and downwards into space. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. What was the monstrous terror? So I'll tell you the meanings in the next video. Okay, children. So how was the terror? Monstrous terror. Very dangerous. Okay. Seized. Monstrous means very fearful. Okay. Next. With a loud scream, he fell towards downwards and into the space. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. See, from top if you fall for 2 minutes, you can't. Suddenly you run and come, or you jump from up for 1 second, 1 minute, we will feel motionless. Even a lizard, take the example of lizard, if it falls from top or from the wall or the roof, it will not move for some time. It will become motionless. Okay, so like that only from top he fell down into the sea. So he became motionless for a minute. The next moment he felt his wings spread out. As he fell into the water, he felt the next moment his wings are moving out. His wings are coming out. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. So in the beach, in the water, you find big wind, isn't it? With that wind, his wings also opened, his breast touched the water, his legs also touched the water. He felt a nice movement. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. Then he felt that his wings are controlling him. As the air is coming, he felt that wings are controlling. Now aeroplane, you see, when it goes up into the air, why it has wings? To control the motion of the air, to control the storm. So like that he felt, oh, I have the help of my wings. He felt a little bit, oh, my wings are helping me, my wings are helping me to control. So he felt like that. He could feel the tips of the wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually to downwards and outwards. He is not soaring. Soaring means going upwards. He was soaring gradually. He wants to go up, to downward, up gradually downwards and headlong now. He was no longer afraid. Now he is not afraid. Once he fell down into the water, he felt that his wings are there is a motion in the wings. His wings are supporting him. His legs are supporting him. His body is supporting him. Then he did not have the fear. Until then, he was fearing that, oh my God, what will happen if I jump into the water? I may die, I think. I can't control these waves, I think. The sea is very deep. The water is very high. So I think I may die. He was feeling. Once he jumped into the water, he got a good strength and energy. How? His wings. Through his wings. He just felt a bit dizzy. Dizzy means what? An uncomfortable feeling of spinning around and losing one's balance. Dizzy means kalitirigatam we say, you feel like he felt something rounding and he was not much active. But later he covered himself. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared upwards. Soared means going up. Okay. Once he flapped his wings, he opened his wings and he flapped like this and he went upwards. Ga 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 kolha. His mother swooped past. His mother also was very very happy. Swooped past means what? She pounced the downwards. She came from top down to the water where seagull is there in the water. She came shoutingly, ga 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 kolha ga kolha. She came to the water. His mother swooped past him, her wings making a loud noise. And his mother is flapping the wings and the wings are making also loud noise. He answered her with another scream. And when mother is shouting, he gave reply to his mother also. Then his father flew over him screaming. Father also flew over him screaming, shouting. Okay. So he saw his two brothers and his sister flying around him. Now father, mother came shoutingly. Next father came. Next his two brothers and sister also came shoutingly, flying around him. Curveting means leaping like a horse, bending and seeing and banking and soaring and diving. Banking and soaring and diving. All of them came, they are supporting him. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly and commanded himself to dive and soar and curve, shrieking shrilly. So he felt, no, I need not afraid now. I can go happily. I can know. Now mother came first. Next father came. Next brothers and sister came. All of them were helping him by shouting. And he got energy from their parents. They were encouraging him. They were feeling proud. They were feeling happy. See, when you get good marks, if all of you congratulate all your family members, your friends, your teachers, if they congratulate you, how do you feel? You feel happy and energetic, isn't it? So like that, he felt very happy and energetic when his mother, father, brothers and sister came and shouted at him, screamed at him and encouraged him. Okay, dear? Now, he was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him with little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. So he was near the sea now. He is moving his beak and playing with the water, with the waves and all. His parents and his brothers and sisters had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. He is also in the water. He means who? Seagull is also in the water now. Parents are also sitting in the water around him. They were beckoning to him. What is meant by beckoning? Signaling. Beckoning means signaling. Signaling to him, calling shrilly. They were signaling him. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. Now, his legs are in the green sea. Next day, his legs sank into it. His legs are also sinking, moving. He screamed with fright and attempted to rise again, flapping his wings. But he was tired and weak with hunger and could not raise. See here, when he was flapping the wings and he was on the water and but he was happy by seeing all his family members. Then suddenly what happened? He tried to sink in that. He want to leave the legs in that. They were signaling from that side. Who were signaling? Family members were signaling him. Do like this. As they were signaling him, what happened? He was getting afraid. He dropped his legs in the legs to stand on the green sea. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. But his legs sank into it. They were moving. He shouted. He was afraid and he shouted. He was frightened and attempted to raise again. Oh my God, I am swimming, I am going away. So let me go away up. He thought and he flapped his wings. But he was tired. He could not get up. Why he could not get up from the water? Because he was hunger. He was very hungry. So from the water, he could not get up and fly again up in the sky. Okay. And he could not raise. Exhausted means very tired by the strange exercise. He was very, very exhausted by the strange exercise. His feet sank into the green sea and then his belly touched it and he sank no farther. He was very hungry. He could not get up. He could not fly up again. So it was like one exercise for him. But the strange exercise, his feet sank into the green sea and then his belly touched it. And he sank no farther. His belly also touched the water and he was just standing in one place in the sea. He can't walk farther. He was floating on it and around him. His family was screaming. He was floating. And who was there around him? Family was there to help him. He was floating on it around him. His family was screaming, praising him, and their beaks were offering him scraps of dogfish. He had made his first flight. He was shouting. He was moving in the water. As he was moving in the water, he don't have energy to fly up. Their family members came to know that. Especially mother. Mother came to know that my son is hungry. So immediately all the family members together, they are very happy by seeing a seagull's hard work trying to fly. So first of all, he was hunger. He was not able to fly up from the water. So his parents and family members bought dogfish. They collected some fish from the sea and pieces. One of them are bringing one piece and putting in the mouth of seagull. So I think you have understood this part. Okay, children. Okay, the meanings, and I'll explain you next part in the next video, and I'll give you the meanings as well. I'll give some animation movie also of this story. You can watch in the next videos. Okay, children, until I'll keep watching. Okay, children, bye.